Tennessee's governor declared a state of emergency to address the spread of the coronavirus. That happened on Thursday. Minority House Leader Karen Camper is the highest-ranking state official from Memphis, and she's been involved in a number of the discussions with the mayor regarding the state's response to the virus. Representative Camper joins us this morning. Good to see you, as always.
Good morning. Good to see you, too.
I know that Nashville is scrambling. First, we had the tornado, which caused all the problems, and then right on the heels. So what does a state of emergency actually mean? Because I know my 16-year-old heard that and had a moment where she was a little afraid. What does it mean, really?
Well, thank you, Mary Beth, for having me, and thank you all for continuing to bring, you know, updates on the situation that's happening around.
It's really changing rapidly.
Because it's changing rapidly. Every 48 hours, there's something else going on. Mm-hmm. If you think back when the hurricanes, tornadoes took place, the governor declared a state of emergency then so that we can get the disaster relief from the federal government, which is about a 60-day period of, you know, opportunities to mend, change, bend the rules to allow us to have quick response to the people.
Take off some of the red tape.
Yes.
Off some organizations, like child care facilities.
Exactly.
I saw as an example.
Yes. And so by declaring a state of emergency for this particular virus, it's similar in nature. So it extends that, first off, for another 60 days. So that's 4 months where we'll be in a state of emergency to deal with these issues. But it also will allow the governor, in this case, to bend the rules to some degree, remove the red tape for hospitals to get safety net funding additionally from federal government as it trickle down through us. Allow for doctors to prescribe, say you now get a 30-day supply of medicine, maybe you can get 45 days so that you don't have to come back in.
Gotcha.
So it allows us to be able to do things like that. And I think that is a good first step for the governor to do, but I also think, you know, there's more we could be doing, and I've talked to him this week, yesterday as a matter of fact, about what more are we doing, can we be doing.
What would you like to see that isn't, that you don't see so far that we need to do?
Well, I think that the governor is having each department develop plans systematically of how to deal with this virus in a methodical, pragmatic way.
Okay.
But I don't know that the citizens know that, so that they can be assured that we are reviewing our plans, that we have things in place, that in 60 days we'll take these steps, in 90 days we'll take these steps, so that the citizens know that we are looking at it, we are being careful. I just don't think that part is being communicated.
So the communication is lacking. It's not so much a matter of transparency. You don't think there's any intention of not communicating.
I mean, because like you said, your daughter, when she heard state of emergency,
she was worried.
That put something in people's mind who don't understand what that means.
Right, that it's just a practical matter.
Right,
really.
But there could have been more to say.
Gotcha.
Because we're in a state of emergency, these are the things that we're going to do.
Was he receptive to that concern?
Yes, he was. I will say that, and even talked to the department, the commissioner of health. Talked to her yesterday, and she's they're very. And she told me she would get with her communications team, and they would begin to do more things like that.
Because you know, with the 24/7 media, the media is definitely ready for more information. They will never.
And that's
not. We won't ever to not take a call.
I agree with that, but that's great for the citizenry because they're going to tune in to Live at 9, if you will, or to the news outlets to see, is there an update? What's going on?
Until they start complaining that we're hyping it up. But that's another whole story. We won't get into that particular pet peeve. What about possible, and I don't even know if this is possible, when I heard, for instance, that last week a Treadwell Elementary employee was told to stay home for 2 weeks, didn't have the virus, but had been in contact with the person who did. Mm-hmm. My initial thought was, will that person have to take vacation days or sick days when being mandated to stay home? What about that person's income? This really could impact a lot of workers, and here in Memphis, we have a lot of folks who are maybe don't have health insurance and are economically challenged. They need that paycheck. So are there any financial Is there an awareness in Nashville that there needs to be?
There is an awareness. That is exactly one of the things that I talked to the governor about, because just think about Memphis, who have a lot of temporary employees. Mm-hmm. And don't have health care.
Right.
You know, a lot of hourly employees.
And lower income levels.
And lower income, right? What are we going to do?
Right.
So the Department of Labor have to look at, well, can we get extended like we did with the stimulus during the other downturn in the economy? Extend benefits.
Like unemployment benefits or something.
Is there money? Are we sending money to businesses or providing grants to businesses to give them the cash flow that they need to keep those employees working or with a salary? Or are we addressing what you're saying about this teacher that,
right,
yeah, they're going home, but they're still receiving a salary?
So, was there receptivity there?
Yes.
Awesome.
We have to, like I said, we got to all hands on deck trying to figure out how to make this work.
Okay.
How do we do it, and how do we do it effectively, efficiently?
Awesome. There are several bills that we'd love to talk with you about. We're out of time right now, but we would love to have you back to talk about the permitless carry and that sort of thing.
So we'll have you back. I would love to do that.
Thank you so much.